so we are team Hakuna Frittata, which means no worries about breakfast. My name's Tony.
I'm Matt Coates.
I'm Adam O'Curry.
Marissa Kinsley. Donovan Higgins.
So like all the other teams, we're faced with the question of how might we improve the health and wellness of Notre Dame students. So we started by individually brainstorming on these how might we worksheets, some ideas about what we thought we could do to improve this health and well-being of Notre Dame students. And when we came together to collaborate on our ideas, we realized that all of us mentioned something about improving the availability of healthy foods on campus, whether that be organic and fresh foods or foods that are tailored towards dietary restrictions like vegetarian options or gluten-free options. So we decided to focus on foods as we moved into our empathy phase to get some feedback from Notre Dame students about what they thought about the current food options on campus. So here's a copy of our initial design brief where we just scoped basically healthy foods, especially vegetarian, organic, and gluten-free options on campus, and identified our target users as well as kind of just planning out our research plan of interviewing Notre Dame students and conducting camera studies to see what Notre Dame students were eating. So we first began, before we talked to any students, we each designed our own storyboards just kind of illustrate certain situations that we've been in or we could think of that negatively illustrated the current food options on campus. So in this situation, there's a girl that's studying late at night at Hesburgh, and it's negative 15 degrees outside. So the only real option that she has is to go down to AVP. And you can kind of see her journey map as she's going through the store, just kind of looking around at everything, not seeing anything that she's particularly interested in. And she ends up buying something that leaves her pretty unsatisfied, and she's hoping that, or she was wishing that she had some healthier options. And then we actually started talking and getting feedback from Notre Dame students through camera studies. So we had a few students just take pictures of everything that they would eat throughout the day. And we kind of put some of those pictures up here. As you can see, there's kind of a big focus on just the convenience over the actual nutritional value. Like one person had 3 chili cheese dogs for lunch one day. All their midday snacks are all just very quick things. But one thing that we really noticed with our camera studies was not one person that we had in our camera studies had any pictures of them eating breakfast. So that's when we started to realize that that the availability of healthy breakfast options on campus must be lacking if no one is even giving it a chance and eating breakfast.
Okay, so when we started this study, we knew that our work was going to revolve around express units, things like the huddle, ABP, subway, that kind of thing. So the best thing we could do to learn more about how express units work is get a one-on-one interview with somebody that runs one. We sat down with Jim Labella, the manager at the huddle and all of the express units at La Fortune, and we wanted to get an idea from him what students like to buy. What did students buy the most? What did they decide to stock? And our most important takeaway from him was students will buy out the healthy options, but coincidentally, they're also the convenient ones. At the time of the interview, the hot item was Quest bars, and before that, it was pita chips, both things that you can take with you on the go. So next we did interviews with students, and this is just a collection of basic overviews of what each student thought. Most of our general takeaways were students were concerned about health, quality of the food, good nutrition. One student in particular noted that they would pay more for this kind of food if it was available on campus. Another one that stuck out to us was student that had a problem getting hot food before class in the morning. This student's story is they go to class in Mendoza, they try to go to the cafe down in the basement, and they would really want to get a sandwich or soup or something, but they just don't have the time to do it, so they get something like a bagel, so they're not completely satisfied. So we took all of the data from our interviews and later observations and put them into a user observation database. In this particular database, we noted that students getting a hold of food on campus and express units is usually requires them to go out of their way. And over here, some of the takeaways we saw, students valued food that was portable and healthy. We also noticed that a lot of students wanted breakfast options, but they were either not there, either they weren't available at all, or that they were just out of stock by the time they got there, which is a pretty big problem. So here is an observation that I found particularly interesting, and it came from what students found about their unhealthy food. They usually gravitated towards unhealthy food because it was convenient. Because there's a lot more unhealthy food out there that's on the go than there is healthy food. So we took this as an indicator that, hey, maybe we need to take a page out of the book of unhealthy food and make the healthy food a little bit more available if we can. So some of the other observations we noticed, we went and watched students as they went into places like Wadix or the Huddle. We wanted to get an idea of what their behavior was like when they were going to get these foods. There was a lot of frustration, particularly when the foods they wanted, like breakfast sandwiches or sweet potatoes, just weren't there. They were out of stock, and they're not happy about what they want not being there. So some of the patterns we noticed from our interviews and observations, students don't really have that much time for breakfast in the dining hall. And we saw that kind of thing in the camera studies, too. Quick options are mostly available, but they're either not nutritious, like the breakfast sandwiches at Wadix that students complain about, or they're just out of stock by the time students get there. Another pattern, hot breakfast options are just inconvenient. Again, Wadix was our big poster boy for that one. So some of the implications here. Students go hungry before lunch, and as such, they're just not able to concentrate as much as they could, and that has impacts on how they study and how they perform in tests and homework. So as such, to adjust from all these observations, we changed our design brief. We wanted to focus now more on getting students the breakfast they need in a convenient and quick manner.
So once we determined that breakfast was the main pain point that we were going to try to solve through all of our ethnographic and other interviews, we were able to break down Notre Dame students into four general personas. Now, with the vertical axis, you have people who eat breakfast regularly and people who don't eat breakfast regularly. On the horizontal axis, you have people who, on the left side, who really care about having a high-quality, nutritious breakfast, and they might be willing to go a little bit more out of their way, maybe pay a little bit more to get that high quality. On the opposite side, you have people who just care mostly about convenience, but being price and time. And so I'll explain a little bit about these each. So top corner is the non-issue crowd. So these are people who are fine with the way things are. They think the Mendoza breakfast sandwiches are perfect as is, and they don't really see much room for improvement. So This quadrant we would not be focusing on. This group is sort of the people, the ones who roll out of bed, whatever they can get on their way. They don't really care. They'll take an old banana that's brown on one side, or you know, whatever. If it won't kill me, I'll eat it. And a lot of our interviewers actually showed this sentiment. So this group, like the last one, would not be our focus. This group is one of our main points of focus, which these are the ones who they don't eat breakfast now, and it's precisely because the options on campus are not sufficient. And some of our interviews really showed this, and they gave all kinds of suggestions, but it was almost like a point of you know, like rebellion that they like wouldn't eat in the morning because they just did not like the options. And then the begrudging breakfast eaters, these are the people who they eat breakfast regularly, but they're still not really satisfied. They do see a lot of room for improvement, And like the last, so these two segments would be our main areas of focus. And now I'm going to present to you a user story to show you the current situation as of now before our group went on this journey. And I had the... breakfast and thus could not pay attention in class, and this whole day was
And so once we really defined who our users were and what their morning routines looked like, we moved into the ideate phase, where we tried to develop potential solutions to their problems and their pain points that they were experiencing through providing healthy breakfast options on campus in a convenient way. So one of the ideas we thought of was an indoor breakfast system that was run by students and provided hot and cold breakfast options in the mornings. Unfortunately, there are some logistical concerns as well as some health issues associated, so we kind of moved away from this concept. Then we looked at the possibility of a smoothie bar for morning protein shakes and various other things. But we decided after discussing this option with other students that this was not an ideal breakfast for a nice icy cold South Bend winter morning. We also considered an on-campus food truck that would pull up to DeBartolo or Mendoza and have various breakfast and lunch options available for students. But the feasibility of this might not be in line with the interests of Notre Dame Food Services right now, as hip as it would be to have a cool Notre Dame food truck. We also then seriously considered a pickup stand for delivery orders from places like ABP or Greenfield. So you would order ahead online and then have a designated pickup spot in DeBartolo or Mendoza or another centralized location. We also looked at a more centralized grab and go, which would include hot food instead of just sandwiches and salads and whatnot. So again, providing hot options for students in the morning was something that was indicated as being a pain point in the past, and this could potentially solve that. And then finally, having pre-made options with individualized toppings, so people could customize their oatmeal or their salad or the breakfast sandwich or whatever food item they would like to select and conveniently go through the process without having to wait in a huge line like the one at Wadex. And so taking all of these ideas and really considering the feedback that we got from people that we showed them to, we developed several prototypes. The first of these was an oatmeal bar with customizable toppings at the end of this oatmeal process. And people indicated that this would definitely be an improvement from the current options that are available at the ABP cart, which only really includes pastries and some fruit and coffee and tea. The next of these prototypes we looked at was the pickup option that I previously described. So having people pre-order online from Green Fields and then having a set time that they could pick it up at their designated pickup spot in DeBartolo. Although people felt that this would definitely improve their willingness to order from Green Fields or ABP, they also felt that they might not be have enough foresight to order ahead to receive these options in DeBartolo. And so taking this feedback into consideration, we really combined the two options and tried to create the best of both worlds. So having an oatmeal bar on one side where students could quickly and easily grab their oatmeal and then customize it to their liking with various toppings, as well as a pickup location so they could order ahead and pick up a breakfast sandwich or pancakes or whatever they would like ahead of time. And with that, we moved into the testing phase.
And as Marissa outlined, we wanted to translate the 2D prototype into something physical that people could interact with and really give us feedback in terms of how it works logistically. And so we went ahead and within the classroom setting, we set up an oatmeal bar as well as a pickup station. So as you can see in this picture, one table is set up. You have both sections cleanly separated, as well as a fridge underneath with simulation of like fruit drinks as well. And we even had a separate table set up for kind of the oatmeal toppings. And while the feedback within the classroom setting was good, one thing that we immediately noticed within our observation was people kind of got logistically confused in terms of where to go to get the oatmeal toppings, as well as to go underneath to reach for the fruit juices. And so kind of learning from that initial launching and learning test, we kind of simplified the idea and it moved it into one kind of consolidated table. So where at one side you have a pickup station, if you have the time to order ahead online, you could just go, show your ID, pick up your order and go to class, or you can also have the oatmeal bar available to you. And so here you can see our particular user, Tony, he's here different weighing the different options available to him. If he has time in between class or when he's like on the go. And for different people who have thought ahead of time to order, they have the option available to them. And so really we went ahead and launched this within the DeBartolo near the computer cluster, and we got a lot of good feedback from different users in terms of we wanted to know, hey, is this convenient? Do you like the locations and what do you think about the options? And the majority of the users said, yes, it's convenient. Compared to the ABP cart, which is conveniently right next to where we were set up, they said, hey, sometimes in the morning, I don't just want pastries and a cup of coffee. People said that they liked the pickup portion and that they would make the time to go ahead and order. And people even gave us constructive criticism in terms of the food that we offered. They said, why not add watermelons and pineapple and diversify the fruit so we're not just seeing the same kind of fruit that we see in the dining hall or Watnex or other different places. We also got feedback in terms of, on the flip side, people saying, you know what, hey, we do kind of want a mundane breakfast, just kind of your basic milk, water. Don't keep it fancy, keep it simple, because in terms of convenience, I just want something that I can go to and grab and go to class. Also, we did kind of get constructive feedback in terms of the ordering online system. We presented people with an inside ND kind of setup, and they really liked that, but some others said they wouldn't really take advantage of that. And so with that, we'd like to present you with the solution and how that really changes and affects the customer journey as they wake up in the morning for class.
Thank you.
And so that is Greenfield Express that we hope that Notre Dame Food Services will kind of take into consideration moving forward. And really kind of our recommendation for the interested stakeholders is to take in mind the whole process of kind of approaching the user, ideating, prototyping, and getting and creating a solution that both they want and feel that they will need. And with that, we will take your questions, and thank you for your time.
So I know we're right at the end of class, and some of you have to get to other classes, so put your green sheets in the box on your way out if you need to leave right away, and if you guys have a minute, we'll do some questions. Okay. All right, nice job, you guys. I'll see you on Monday in Gio Panini.
I have a question for you guys. Like, did you guys find that, this could, just with him eating in class, would that be distracting?
We did take that into consideration, especially during the process, and that was a lot of feedback that we did get. But I think that in terms of, that's why we chose to focus on just oatmeal, because it is kind of a quiet snack. Before, during the prototyping process, we had breakfast sandwiches, salads, and kind of the whole dishing out, the whole variety. Because of those concerns, we really wanted, and in terms of convenience, to keep it to oatmeal, which is quiet in terms of in class. Yeah.
And a question on the two groups you identified that this would be applicable to in your test. What percentage of the students fell within those two categories?
Certainly more than half, I would say, fell into those two groups. I can't really recall interviewing anyone that was completely satisfied with the breakfast offerings. People were either I don't care about it, or they said, I'm not okay with if there's a lot of room for improvement, so.
I think the only one that I had out of my five that I conducted personally was the one who had the direct quote, if it doesn't kill me, I will eat it. So I think that shows his extremism.
Did you find it beneficial or a detractor to move a bunch of concepts into prototyping, or would you rather not done it that way, or any benefits identified?
I thought that was a good way of doing it because we didn't even have to ask people, oh, come over and look at our station. They just walked over and they're like, oh, what is this? And then they heard about it. And the Aubon Pan Express, they don't even have milk for your coffee. It's very, it's very rudimentary. So the idea of a Greenfields Express, especially people who have been to Greenfields, they thought it was awesome and they all gravitated towards our station.
Thank you, you're doing a great job.
Thank you. Thank you.